In this video, I'm going to show you how to replace a system of three-dimensional forces acting on a body by a force-coupled system at a specified point. And I'm going to solve this problem which you see on your screen. First, let's briefly go through the basic concepts that need to be understood for solving the problem. In one of my previous videos relating to coplanar or two-dimensional forces, I had explained in detail how to replace coplanar forces by a force-coupled system. And the basic concept that I talked about is this. Suppose you have a rigid body on which a force is acting, and the point of application of the force is point A, and if you want to shift the point of application of this force to some arbitrary point such as O, which does not happen to be lying on the line of action of this force, you can do so, but you have to add a couple as shown here in this diagram. The moment of that couple is equal to the force magnitude times the perpendicular distance from this point to the line of action of the force. So as long as you add this moment, you can shift the point of application of the force from A to O. So this force coupled system is equivalent to this force in the sense the effect, the pushing and turning effect of this force coupled system on this body is the same as the pushing and turning effect of this force acting at point A. So in that sense, these two systems are equivalent, and this force could be replaced by this force coupled system acting at point O. And when you come to three-dimensional forces, the basic concept or principle is the same, and therefore solution to this problem which you see on the left is going to be easy. Okay, so let's go ahead and solve this problem. There are four forces acting on this machine component, and we have to replace these four forces by a force coupled system acting at point A. First, we shift the point of application of all these forces to point A, and let's say the resultant of those concurrent forces at A is R. And let's say the sum of moments of the individual forces about point A is M. So R is the force of our force coupled system, and M is the moment of the couple due to all these four forces. So we have to find R and M. So the force R is sum of the individual forces. Let's label these forces as F1, F2, F3 and F4. F1 is minus 300i, F2 is minus 120i, F3 is minus 50j and F4 is minus 250k. So we sum them and we end up with R is minus 420i, minus 50j, minus 250k newtons. So that's the first part. Now we have to compute the moment M. And to find out the moment, we are going to follow the scalar method instead of the vector method. Okay? So M is sum of the individual moments. So now examine the moment of each of the force about point A. So F1, as you notice, is passing through point A and therefore has zero moment about A. So F1 contributes no moment. In order to find moment of this force F2 about point A, we can compute the moment of this force about the individual axis. And the sum of those three moments would be the moment of F2 about point A. So let's examine what is the moment of this force about axis X. This F2 force is parallel to X and therefore contributes no moment about the X axis. About Y axis, it has a moment in this direction, in this direction. And as per right hand rule, this would mean moment in this direction. And the moment arm for this force would be this distance, which is 160 mm or 0.16 meters. So the second term is 120 times 0.16, and the minus sign is because it's pointing towards minus y direction. Now let's examine the moment of force F2 about z axis. And yes, indeed, it has a moment, and that moment would be like this. And as per right hand rule, it will be pointing towards minus z axis. And the moment arm for this moment would be the distance 100 mm or 0.1 meters. So we have minus 120 into 0.1 in k direction, right? Now let us examine the moment of force F3. F3 intersects axis x and therefore has no moment. It is also parallel to y axis and therefore it has no moment about y axis. Indeed, it has moment about the z axis and that will be in this direction or like this. And therefore the moment vector would be pointing towards the minus z direction. Therefore we have minus 50 times 0.2, which is the moment arm. It is this distance. Now we turn to force F4. F4 intersects x-axis and therefore has no moment about x-axis. It is parallel to z-axis, therefore it does not have any moment about the z-axis, but it has moment about the y-axis and that will be in this direction, like this. And therefore it will be like this. And therefore the moment vector as per right-hand rule would be pointing upwards or towards the positive y-axis. And therefore we have a plus sign here and 250 times the moment arm, which again is this distance, which is 0.2 meters. So we have 250 times 0.2 j, right? So we simplify this expression here and it works out to 30.8 j minus 22 k Newton meter. So this is the moment and this is the force of the force coupled system, and that's the answer. So I hope you found this useful, and if you have liked the video, please share it with your friends and give your thumbs up, and please do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. And see you in the next video. Thank you.